First verse is found in Luke chapter 3, verse 21. We find our Lord Jesus Christ praying soon after he was baptized. Now when all the people were baptized, it came to pass that Jesus also being baptized and praying, the heaven was opened.
जब सबै मानिसहरूले बप्तिस्मा लिए तब यस्तो भयो येशूले पनि बप्तिस्मा लिएर प्रार्थना गर्दै गर्नुहुँदा स्वर्ग खोलियो.
This is the beginning of the public ministry of the Lord Jesus Christ.
प्रभु येशू मसीहको यो चाहिँ एउटा सेवाकाको सुरुवात हो.
There was no necessity for him to pray, him to be baptized.
प्रभु येशू मसीहले बप्तिस्मा लिनु दरकार थिएन.
But he was baptized like any other sinner. They were coming, lining up to be baptized. There was no necessity for him to be baptized. There was no repentance. There was no necessity of repentance. He was the Holy Son of God. But he, at the very beginning of his ministry, he identified himself with the sinner. When people were looking from a distance, what did they see? People lining up, coming one by one, confessing their sins and being baptized. The person looking from a distance would have thought, oh, there's another man is going. When the Lord Jesus was going, they would have thought, oh, another sinner is going. The Holy Son of God identified himself with the sinful man. Same thing happened at the cross also. It was a common sight. So many people were put to death on a cross, a common gallows. That day three crosses were there. And people were passing by. From a distance they would have looked at the three crosses. Oh, there are three sinners, three criminals being hung. Only a few people knew what was going on there. But they would have simply identified the Lord Jesus with any other sinner. This is the purpose unto which our Lord came into the world. He came on our behalf for us. So he identified himself with the sinner. So at the beginning of the public ministry, he went into the water, was baptized in the water. As he came out of the water, he started praying. We do not know what he prayed for. Because the prayer is not written down. But he prayed. But three answers we can see. We can't see what he prayed for. But we find three things that happened. What are the three things? Number one, verse 21, Luke chapter 3, verse 21, last line. Heaven was opened. Number two, the Holy Spirit descended in a bodily shape like a dove upon him. Number three, a voice came from heaven the voice of God the Father. So dear brothers and sisters, let us at the beginning of this holy convocation pray that such things will happen in our midst. Heaven must be opened. Our Lord Jesus very clearly said, unless it is given to any man from heaven, he cannot receive any heavenly thing. Heaven is closed up for human beings until and unless God opens it.
We
can be greatly educated, but we cannot understand any spiritual truth unless it is given to us by God from heaven. This is a very important truth. Let us pray for an open heaven. Open heaven does not mean, sometimes we have a superficial idea about open heaven, that we receive some good message, that we will be very happy. We heard so many things today, but that is not the result of heaven being open. That God will reveal something that is so relevant and applicable uniquely to you. Very often during a message, I fall into this temptation. I don't know about you. About me, I'm talking. Oh, I hear a message. I look around. Oh, they're good for that man. That good. This message is good for that man. Yes, I am trying to apply the message to various people. That means heaven was not open for me. I have not received that spiritual quickening. This will come from heaven. And there was secondly that demonstration of the Holy Spirit of God. There was no necessity for that to happen. Our Lord Jesus was full of the Holy Spirit all the time. Now John the Baptist was filled with the Holy Spirit of God from mother's womb. But our Lord Jesus was greater than that. How much greater? He was with the Holy Spirit of God throughout eternity. So there was no need for the Holy Spirit to come upon him at that time. The need was for us, that we may see that. And Matthew writes that, Luke writes that down. So dear brothers and sisters, the Spirit of God must come down upon us in a new way. He is indwelling us. And we have him. But now we need the definite and forceful working of the Holy Spirit of God in our
lives.
The voice of the Father was heard. Pray today, dear brothers and sisters, that the voice of God may be heard. We can stand against the voice of man, But none of us can stand against the voice of God. The voice of God must be heard. So these are things that we must now concentrate during our time of prayer. So the first recorded instance of prayer in the life of the Lord Jesus is out of the 28 instances. First one is this
Luke 3:21.
The second verse is Mark 1:35. Mark chapter 1 and verse 35. And in the morning, rising up a great while before day, he went out and departed into a solitary place, and there prayed.
अनि बिहान उज्यालो हुनुभन्दा धेरै पहिले नै उठेर वहाँ बाहिर निस्कनु भयो र एउटा एकान्त स्थानमा जानुभयो र त्यहाँ प्रार्थना गर्नुभयो.
Dear brothers and sisters, before the day dawn, before his ministry started, we find the Lord Jesus spending time in prayer before the Father.
प्रिय दाजुभाइ दिदीबहिनीहरु, परमेश्वर मसीहले आफ्नो सेवाकाज सुरु गर्नुभन्दा अगाडि दिनभरको सेवाको अगाडि सकारै बिहान भइतिर उहाँले पितालाई प्रार्थनामा समय व्यतीत गर्नुभयो.
There he receives the plan for the day.
अनि त्यो दिनको लागि योजना उहाँले त्यहाँ प्राप्त गर्नुभयो.
The disciples went after him. Simon went and those who were with him also went after him. And they said, when they found the Lord Jesus praying, they said, all the people are looking for you. Please come.
अनि जब परमेश्वर मसीहलाई प्रार्थना गरिरहेको उनीहरूले भेट्यो अनि भने तपाईँलाई अरू मान्छेले कतै छ आउनुहोस् भनिकन.
But verse 38,
38 पदमा
he said unto them, let us go into the next town.
अनि उहाँले भन्नुभयो हामी अरू अरू गाउँहरूमा पनि जाऊ.
That I may preach there also.
अनि त्यहाँ गएर त्यहाँ पनि म प्रचार गरौँ.
See, but Simon Peter and the others thought was, already we have a good congregation here. Lord Jesus, you preach here.
अनि सिमोन पत्रुस र उनको साथीहरूले भन्दै थिए, यहाँनिर एउटा भीड भेला भइसकेको छ, आएर यो प्रार्थना प्रचार गर्नुहोस् भनेर उनीहरूले भने.
According to the perception of the disciples, this need of the people here was so great.
अनि चेलाहरूको भनाइ अनुसार चाहिँ यहाँ भएको मान्छेहरूको आवश्यकता ठुलो थियो.
But having spent time early in the morning in the presence of the Father, the Lord Jesus says, no, let us go to the other towns.
तर बिहानका बिहानै प्रार्थनामा जब समय व्यतीत गर्नुभयो अनि परमेश्वर पिताको जो योजना अनुसार उहाँले अर्कै गाउँहरूमा जाने उहाँहरूलाई गर्नुभयो.
Please, dear brothers and sisters, we must pray now during our prayer time regarding this.
प्रिय दाजुभाइ दिदीबहिनीहरू, यी कुरालाई स्मरण गर्दै हामी प्रार्थनाको समयमा प्रार्थना गरौँ.
What man thinks that is essential for us today may be different to what God thinks.
आज मान्छेले जे कुरा सोचिरहेको छ त्यो चाहिँ परमेश्वरले सोचेको भन्दा चाहिँ मान्छेको चाहिँ फरक हुन सक्छ.
Pray for the messengers of God.
अनि परमेश्वरको सन्देश वाहकहरूको लागि प्रार्थना गरौँ.
They will think that, oh, this message is good for the congregation.
अनि उनीहरूले हुन सक्छ यो झुन्डहरूको लागि यो चाहिँ मेसेज सन्देश असल छ भनेर.
Every messenger, we must strive hard to arrive at that which is in the heart of God.
अनि आज यस्तो सन्देश बाहकले सन्देश दिन सकोस् कि जो परमेश्वरको हृदयको कुरा छ त्यो ल्याएर चाहिँ परमका जनहरूलाई दिन सकौँ.
I am speaking on behalf of all the messengers, those who preach at the Bible study, evening meeting, afternoon meeting, family prayer, on behalf of all I am speaking.
अनि मैले चाहिँ सबै सन्देश बाहकहरूको समक्ष उनीहरूको समक्ष पनि मैले भनिरहेको छु, जसले बिहानको पारिवारिक सेवा दिन्छन्, बेलुकाको पारिवारिक सेवा, दाजुभाइ दिदीबहिनीहरूको सेवामा बच्चन उहाँहरूले वाचन गर्छन्.
Among our believers, dear brothers and sisters, we are regular speakers.
हामी चाहिँ प्रिय दाजुभाइ दिदीबहिनीहरू, हाम्रा दाजुभाइ दिदीबहिनीहरूको समक्ष हामी चाहिँ सधैँ हामी वचन बाँड्नेहरू हो.
The last 5 days also I have been speaking so many times.
गएका 5 दिनहरूमा चाहिँ मैले पनि धेरै पटक वचन बाँड्नु परेको थियो.
So we get used to it.
हामी त एकदमै बानी परिसकेका छौँ.
You must have pity upon preachers.
हामी चाहिँ एकदमै प्रचारकलाई सुन्ने बानी परिरहेका छौँ.
And we find it quite easy to get up on the pulpit and preach something.
हामी त एकदमै पुल्पिटमा उत्रिएर बाइबल समातेर प्रचार गर्न हामीलाई केही एकदमै अनौठो कुरा हुँदैन.
And we are falling into a trap. To easily come to a decision. Okay, this is the message. Do not strive hard on the knees to find what the message is for the Lord, Lord's people in a particular place. We will be fighting in vain.
We have
so many stories lined up. Beautiful illustrations are there. We have well established so many messages already. Sevenfold, twelvefold, tenfold. We can keep on giving. But it will not bring any blessing to the preacher or to the listeners. Having spent time that early morning, the Lord knew where the need was. He changed the natural and establish the spiritual.
Oh, permission let's say prakriti kura lacha adal badal garera permission le chai teslai chai aphno aatmik kura ma parivartan garna sakchha.
The natural was to stand there and preach for the rest of the day.
Oh, ani parantar le chai din bhari chai prachar garna sakinchha.
But the spiritual, that is the Father's will, was to go to the other towns.
Oh, tara aatmik tar le pita le parmeshwar pita le dine kura chai arko gau ma chai janu bhanu bhayeko
chha. Please pray for the preachers.
Kripaya pracharakko lagi chai prarthana gardina hola.
That they will be able to give up the natural and take hold on the spiritual.
Oh, uniharu le prakritik kura lai chai chhodera aatmik kura lai chai uniharu le chai dina sakun.
We'll move on. We are only looking at 7 verses, so out of the 28. So we'll move on to the third one, please, quickly.
Luke 6:12.
Luke chapter 6 and verse 12. And it came to pass in those days that he went out into a mountain to pray and continued all night in prayer to God.
अनि ती दिनहरुमा यस्तो भयो, उहाँ पहाडमा प्रार्थना गर्न जानुभयो र परमेश्वरलाई प्रार्थना गर्नमा सारा रात बिताउनुभयो.
Praying all night alone in the mountain. Dear brothers and sisters, that is a difficult thing to do. But our Lord prayed all night. We may have good intentions like that, but we fail halfway through.
Oh, हामीले चाहिँ यो इच्छा लिएर हामी चाहिँ चाहना लिएर गरौँला तर आधा बाटोमा पुगिकन चाहिँ हामी यसलाई पुरा गर्न
सक्दैनौँ.
अनि उहाँले केका निम्ति प्रार्थना गर्नुभयो त?
You can see that when we come with him next day morning, down coming down the mountain, what he did.
अनि हामीले चाहिँ यसको के को लागि प्रार्थना गर्नुभयो भन्ने कुरालाई बुझ्नको लागि जब उहाँ चाहिँ पहाडबाट तल झर्नुभयो अर्को बिहान त्यो कुराबाट हामी बुझ्न सक्छौँ.
He came down the mountain and he began to call the disciples.
उहाँ जब चाहिँ त्यो पहाडबाट तल झर्नुभयो अनि चेलाहरूलाई उहाँले बोलाउनु भयो.
Verse 13, and when it was day, he called unto him his disciples, and of them he chose 12, whom also he named apostles.
अनि जब दिन भयो तब उहाँले आफ्ना चेलाहरूलाई बोलाउनु भयो र तिनीहरूबाट उहाँले 12 जनालाई छान्नु भयो जसलाई उहाँले प्रेरित भन्ने नाम पनि दिनुभयो.
Dear brothers and sisters, this is the place where we see the where we are touching the sovereignty of God. Our Lord Jesus was as a man on the face of the earth, he was touching the sovereignty of God.
प्रिय दाजुभाइ दिदीबहिनीहरु, यहाँ प्रभु येशु ख्रीष्ट चाहिँ तपाईहरुमा जस्तै एउटा व्यक्ति हुनुहुन्थ्यो, मान्छे हुनुहुन्थ्यो, तापनि यहाँ परमेश्वरको सार्वभौमिकतालाई हामी यहाँ देख्न सक्छौँ.
Verse 16.
16 पद.
And Judas, the brother of James, and Judas Iscariot, which also was the traitor.
अनि याकुबको भाइ यहुदा, यहुदा र यहुदा इस्करियोती जो विश्वासघाती पनि भयो.
This is called the sorrowful ingredient of prayer.
अनि यसलाई चाहिँ एकदमै दुःखदायी प्रार्थनाको मिसावट भनेर भन्न सक्छौँ.
थ्रु प्रेयर नॉट ओन्ली द विल अफ गॉड इज एस्टैब्लिश्ड बट अल्सो द सोवरेनिटी अफ गॉड.
हो यहाँ प्रार्थना चाहिँ प्रभुले प्रार्थना मात्रै गर्नु भएन तर प्रार्थनामा चाहिँ परमेश्वरको सार्वभौमिकतालाई चाहिँ यहाँ समावेश गर्नुभएको
थ्रुआउट इन हिज कम्युनियन विद द फादर.
अनि परमेश्वर पितासँग जो उहाँले वार्तालाप गरिरहनु भएको थियो,
वन बाइ वन दिस नेम्स अफ दिस डिसिपल्स वुड हैव बीन डिस्कस्ड.
अनि चेलाहरूको एक एक नाम लिएर परमेश्वर पितालाई बताइरहनु भएको थियो,
वन बाइ वन
एक एक गरिकन.
एन्ड देन यु कम टु द नेम जुडास इस्करियोट.
जब युदा इस्करियोटको नाम आयो,
द वन टु betrayed the Lord Jesus.
Just the purpose Krishna said, "Pakai diyo."
But that was sealed up, and yes, it has to be done that way.
Oh, yes, the number of people who are living here is saying, "Act like that."
This part we cannot fully understand. We cannot visit this fully, but we know that there was that deep communion with the Father in the establishment of the sovereign will of God.
Oh, you people are having trouble. Maybe I can put the sort there. No, but permission.
कार्य
परमेश्वरको इच्छालाई पनि हामीले बुझ्न सक्दछौं.
Human eye cannot see these things.
अनि मान्छेको आँखाले यी कुराहरू देख्न सक्दैन.
Only God's people can in some measure understand this.
अनि परमेश्वरका जनहरूले मात्र केही स्तरमा यी कुरा बुझ्न सक्दछन्.
The very person who was going to betray the Lord Jesus was appointed through communion with the Father.
अनि यस्तो मान्छे जुन प्रभु येशु ख्रीष्टलाई पक्राइ दिदैछ त्यो मान्छेलाई पनि आज परमेश्वर पिता सँग गरिकन परमेश्वरले अभिषेक गर्नुहुन्छ.
नेक्स्ट रेफरेंस मथ्यु चैप्टर 4.
मथ्युको किताब 4 अध्याय अर्को रेफरेंस.
मथ्यु चैप्टर 4 वर्स 1.
मथ्युको किताब 4 को 1 वर्स.
देन वाज जीसस लेड अप ऑफ द स्पिरिट इनटू द विल्डरनेस टू बी टेम्प्टेड ऑफ द डेविल.
तब शैतानद्वारा परीक्षा गरिनलाई येशू आत्माद्वारा उजाड स्थानमा लग्नु भयो.
Then verse 2. And when he had fasted 40 days and 40 nights, he was afterward and hungered.
अनि 40 दिन र 40 रात उपवास बस्नु भएपछि उहाँ भोकाउनु भयो.
Then verse 11.
Then
the devil leaveth him, and behold, angels came and ministered unto him.
अनि त्यसपछि शैतानले उहाँलाई छोड्यो अनि हेर स्वर्गदूतहरू आएर उहाँको सेवा गरे.
Verse 2 says that he fasted 40 days and 40 nights.
दुई पदमा लेखिएको छ उहाँ चाहिँ 40 दिन 40 रात उपवास बस्नु भयो भनेर.
What do you think that he was doing without taking food? What was he doing in the wilderness?
अनि त्यो वरुद्धानमा उहाँले चाहिँ के गरिरहनु भएको थियो खाना नखाइकन?
Making a study tour of all the birds.
हाम्रो प्रभु येशू ख्रीष्टले 40 दिन 40 रात चाहिँ उपवास चाहिँ प्राप्त गर्नुभयो.
And the devil was all the time around him.
अनि शैतान चाहिँ उहाँको यो सबै समय वरिपरि थियो.
It is not only that after the 40 days were over that day the devil came to him.
अनि त्यो 40 दिन समाप्त भएपछि मात्र शैतान आएको भनेर होइन.
He was all throughout there.
शैतान चाहिँ त्यो सबै समयमा त्यही परिपरि नै थियो.
Troubling the Lord Jesus.
परमेश्वर कृष्णलाई दुःख दिइरहेको थियो.
That was the given work. He was totally dedicated to that work of trying to make things difficult for the Lord Jesus.
उसले चाहिँ आज त्यहाँनिर जो काम दिएको थियो परमेश्वर कृष्णलाई काम गर्नको लागि कठिनाई बनाउनको लागि यो सारा कार्य गरिरहेको थियो.
Our Lord Jesus fasted and prayed.
हाम्रो प्रभु येशु ख्रीष्टले उपवासै प्राप्त गर्नुभयो.
That is what he did 40 days and 40 nights.
उहाँले 40 रात 40 दिनसम्म यो काम गर्नुभयो.
Communion with the Father.
परमेश्वर पितासँग उहाँले वार्तालाप गर्नुभएको थियो.
And thereafter we have recorded instance of 3 temptations.
त्यहाँ लेखिएको छ मलाई तीनवटा चाहिँ त्यहाँ परीक्षा गरियो भनेर.
And then later we are told that then the devil leaveth him. Dear brothers and sisters, we must understand, as I said in the very beginning, that the devil is working around us. To bring discouragement and dissension also. Dissatisfaction. And also disillusion. Not able to understand what's going on. So we must pray. We must pray through. We have only less than 1 hour of prayer. But remember, the Lord prayed for 40 days and 40 nights. At the beginning of his ministry. And we can see the result of that. How the evil one lost its power. Many evil spirits came shouting out of people. And many were delivered from bondage to sin.
So
let us expect these things as we pray. Verse number 5, Luke chapter 5, please. Luke chapter 5 and verse 15. But so much the more when there fame abroad of him, and great multitudes came together to hear and to be healed by him of their infirmities. Verse 16 says, he withdrew himself into the wilderness and prayed. His fame was everywhere. The Bible says great multitudes came to hear him. But the very next verse says, he withdrew himself. One great writer on prayer, Mr. Bounds, says that when the Lord looked at the people, great multitude coming, the Lord saw also Satan coming with the crowd. Yes. So we must understand that the Lord considered withdrawing himself and praying was far more important than meeting the needs of all those people who had come. Can we think like that? Can we think like the Lord Jesus? If we hear of the testimonies regarding Brother Baksin, that he was like that. Our Lord Jesus did not go by the demand and the need among the people.
Because
he knew that will be a very deceptive thing. He withdrew himself and spend time in prayer. Next verse, John chapter 6, verse 15. John chapter 6 and verse 15. And when Jesus therefore perceived that they would come and take him by force to make him a king, he departed again into a mountain himself alone.
Any
time when he departed anywhere alone, it was not to be just to be alone and waste some time. He went there to spend time with the Father. He was going to be given that title, King of the Jews.
But
he knew that that title cannot be taken like that. They came to take hold of him and make him king. Not because that they really loved him and honored him. Because they had eaten well and now they like to have a person like this so that they won't have to work anymore. But the moment the Lord saw that, he withdrew himself into a solitary place, departed to a mountain himself alone. Him being alone was not actually being alone, it was spending time with the Father. So shall we spend really true quality time with the Father? Next verse, Mark chapter 7. Mark chapter 7 verse
33.
Mark 7 and verse 33. And he took him aside from the multitude and put his fingers into his ears, and he spit and touched his tongue. And 34, and looking up to heaven, he sighed and saith unto him, Ephphatha, that is, be
opened.
He could have healed that person without doing any of those things. But can you see that he touched the tongue of this person? He put his fingers into his ears. Then what did he do? He looked up. Heaven. Where the Father is. He would not do this miracle until he was in full communion and fellowship with the Father. He was not performing any miracle independent of the Father.
I'm
very sure that the Lord actually prayed when he looked up. We sometimes show that like we are praying, but we are not praying.
We are
sometimes look up like this, but we don't see anything. But the Lord Jesus looked up. Why? He was not looking at the stars. He was looking at the Father. To be in communion with the Father. The life of the Father flowing through him. How much we should desire these things, dear brothers and sisters. So tonight, the prayer is going to benefit every one of us. When we look up to the Father, गर्नुपर्छ डिफिटिङ ऑल द वर्क अफ द इविल वन अनि जो दुष्टको काम छ त्यो सबै हार्नुपर्छ लिबरेटिङ अस फ्रॉम द बिसेटिङ सिन्स अनि जो चाहिँ हामीलाई सिनले जो पापले अलग पारेको छ त्यो पनि तपाईहरुमा चाहिँ स्वतन्त्र हुनुपर्छ गिविंग अस द फ्रीडम अफ द स्पिरिट अनि जो पापबाट तपाईहरुमा पूर्ण स्वतन्त्रता हुनुपर्छ राइट प्रेयर इज गोइंग टु अकम्प्लिश great things
ajako raat ko prarthana le chha chuna dherai kura cha prapta garnu parecha
so dear brothers and sisters now let us go into a time of prayer
priya dajubha didi bhai le cha aba prarthana ma samay byakti gardai
chha we only remaining about 40 minutes of prayer
aba hami sanga 40 minute matra baki
chha but we can go beyond
tara tyo samay bhanda agadi jana sakchau
please look to heaven
ani kripaya swarga tira hernus
please call upon god
कृपया परमेश्वरलाई पुकार्नुहोस्
सी आवर लॉर्ड जीसस क्राइस्ट स्टैंडिंग एट द राइट हैंड ऑफ द फादर
परमेश्वर परमेश्वर मसीह पिताको जो दाहिने हाततर्फ मेरो भएको छ होला
हेर्नु इंटरसीडिंग ऑन आवर बिहाफ
अनि उहाँले चाहिँ तपाईले मेरो पक्षमा अन्तर्विधि गरिरहनु भएको छ
एंड वी नीड नाउ सी दैट वी कैन कम विथ अ वेरी क्लियर कॉन्शियंस थ्रू द स्प्रिंकलिंग ऑफ द प्रेशियस ब्लड
अनि तपाईहरुमा चाहिँ परमेश्वर मसीहको बहुले लगको छिटकोद्वारा शुद्ध विवेक लिएर हामी त्यो सिंहासनमा अघि आउँ।
Shall we now pray and begin to pray immediately now?
अब हामी तत्कालै प्रार्थना गर्न सुरु गर्न सक्छौँ।
Yes, the time allocated for practical reasons is up to 6:40.
हामीले चाहिँ 6:40 सम्म समय तालिका दिएको छ।
Shall we pray? Any brother, please start praying, and then after that, brother and sister, we can continue to pray.
कृपया कुनै पनि दाजुभाइले पहिला प्रार्थना सुरु गर्नुहोस् अनि त्यसपछि